is to likely focus on areas of interest highlighted in the medical history and may not include everything listed above. The treatment plan may include ordering additional medical laboratory tests and medical imaging studies, starting therapy, referral to a specialist, or watchful observation. Follow-up may be advised depending upon the health insurance plan and the managed care system. Various forms of utilization review, such as prior authorization of tests, may place barriers on accessing expensive services. The medical decision-making process involves analysis and synthesis of all the above data to come up with a list of possible diagnoses. The differential diagnosis, along with an idea of what needs to be done to obtain a definitive diagnosis that would explain the patient's problem. On subsequent visits, the process may be repeated in an abbreviated manner to obtain any new history, symptoms, physical findings, and lab or imaging results or specialist consultations. Contemporary medicine is in general conducted within healthcare systems. Legal credentialing and financing frameworks are established by individual governments, augmented on occasion by international organizations such as churches. The characteristics of any given healthcare system have significant impact on the way medical care is provided. From ancient times, Christian emphasis on practical charity gave rise to the development of systematic nursing and hospitals, and the Catholic Church today remains the largest non-governmental provider of medical services in the world. Advanced industrial countries, with the exception of the United States and many developing countries, provide medical services through a system of universal health care that aims to guarantee care for all through a single player health care system or compulsory private or cooperative health insurance. This is intended to ensure that the entire population has access to medical care on the basis of need rather than ability to pay. Delivery may be via private medical practices or by state-owned hospitals and clinics, or by charities, most commonly by a combination of all three. Most tribal societies provide no guarantee of health care for the population as a whole. In such societies, health care is available to those that can afford to pay for it or have self-insured it, either directly or as part of an employment contract, or who may be covered by care financed by the government or tribe directly. Transparency of information is another factor defining a delivery system. Access to information on conditions, treatments, quality, and pricing greatly affects the choice by patients, consumers, and therefore the incentives of medical professionals. While the US healthcare system has come under fire for lack of openness, new legislation may encourage greater openness. Stop. So friends, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and thank you.